Hello, and welcome to this episode of Stacking Solutions Labs and Demos. Today, we'll be going over master backup on the SG550XG and SG350XG series managed switches. For a stack to operate, it must have a master unit. This switch handles the configuration of the entire stack. If the master unit should fail, another unit must be available to serve as the new stack master. This unit is called the master backup. In this video, we will go over stack unit failures and the resulting master backup processes. Let's get started. When setting up a stack of four SG550XG switches in a ring topology, we can see that unit 1 is the master unit within the stack, unit 2 is the master backup, and units 3 and 4 are the slave units. If one of the links to the master unit fails, the unit will still serve as a stack master. However, the stack will revert to a chain topology. If the master unit is disconnected from the stack at all points, the new stack will contain only units 2, 3, and 4, with unit 2 assuming the new master role. This is called a switchover, where the backup unit takes over the master role and maintains the operation of the stack. In order for the backup to become the master, both units must maintain a warm standby at all times. In a warm standby, both the master and its backup units are synchronized with the static configuration. When the backup unit becomes the master, all of its processes and stack protocols are initialized to take responsibility for the entire stack. As a result, there is temporarily no traffic forwarded to this unit. When the backup unit becomes the master, the initial slave units remain active and continue to forward packets based on the configuration from the original master. This minimizes data traffic interruption. Once the backup unit has completed the transition to the master state, it individually resets the default configuration for each slave. This helps prevent configuration errors during the switchover. If the original master unit is reconnected after the switchover, the new master or original backup unit reboots and becomes the backup once again, while the original master unit assumes the master role. The master backup process is an efficient way for a stack to continue to function normally in the event of a unit or link failure. If the master unit fails, the backup unit assumes the master role and continues to function as the master. This switchover prevents the failure of the master from causing the entire stack to fail. This concludes our tutorial on master backup for the SG550XG and the SG350XG switches. For more information, please check out the Cisco Small Business Support Community for assistance. I'm Lisa from Cisco, and thanks for watching this episode of Stacking Solutions Labs and Demos.